And at this point, we'll introduce John McGarry, who will conduct the next induction. John McGarry, the director of our Lakeshore Museum Center here, and a great supporter of all things Irish. Mr. McGarry.
Thank you very much. I'm greatly honored to be a part of these festivities and recognition of these individuals. The person I'm introducing is Thomas Hume, one of our very own from here in Muskegon. Thomas Hume was born in County Down in 1848. He was the second of eight children. At 14, he was apprenticed to a wholesale grocer, and this became the beginning of his entrepreneurial and business endeavors. I'm very proud to tell you that through the generosity of the Hume descendants, we have that original indenture form in the archival collections of the Lakeshore Museum Center. In 1866, in that second wave that's been previously alluded to, he took passage for America. Like most at that time, this was long before Ellis Island was opened, he came through Quebec, and he headed immediately to Marshall, Michigan, where he began working. In 1870, he had worked his way across to Muskegon, Michigan. The industry was lumber, and he began working at a number of lumber mills. He had been educated, had some training in bookkeeping, and was of an incredibly sharp mind. In 1872, he was able to purchase a share of a mill and became partners with a man by the name of Charles Hackley. They would become the most successful lumber business in Michigan and throughout the Midwest. And as I was sitting here looking out at this beautiful lake, I was thinking to myself that the Hackley and Hume Mill was located about 75 yards right over there. In time, they would begin to expand to other business ventures. Hackley and Hume's company were instrumental in bringing many new businesses and creating many new jobs here in Muskegon, many of which Thomas Hume would serve on the board of and help them prosper, like Continental Motors, Brunswick, and others. In 1873, Thomas married Margaret Ann Banks, and together they had seven children, which they raised in their home right up the hill. In the latter years of his life, like Charles Hackley, he would become philanthropic and supported many institutions in this town, most notably the Hume Home for the Aged, which is still with us today. Here today to represent the Hume family and receive this award are two of his descendants, his great-great-granddaughters, Helen and Elizabeth Sherman.
We're honored to accept this award to Thomas Hume for his philanthropy. While, of course, being Irish, his home country was very dear to him, Muskegon was his second home. And what Charles Hackley, because Muskegon had been good to him, he believed in giving back to his community. So we're pleased to accept this honor of his legacy. Thank you.
He built a Ford plant in Ireland and was the largest employer for many years in the country of Ireland. And as owner of the Ford Motor Company, he became one of the wealthiest and best-known people in the world. Henry Ford isn't with us to accept today, obviously. And the award, we were hoping for a representative, but evidently we're going to present that award later. Is that correct? So something that's not made. Anyway, I'm proud to introduce as the inductee Henry Ford. Yeah.
Before we conclude, I wanted to introduce our board members from the Muskegon Irish American Society. Many of us are involved in the festival here. You've already met Kevin Donovan, our president, Mary Ann Gorman. Would you please stand? Kathleen Merritt, Dee Carlson, David McIntyre, and Ruth Duff. This concludes our ceremony. We have to clear the stage for the next act that's going to be here, but all the inductees are going to go over to the pavilion tent, the permanent structure, the Johnson Pavilion, and they'll be able to greet you and discuss things there with you. And so please join us over there after the ceremony here now. Thank you very much for attending.